I'd like to call the special meeting of the Lord Selkirk West Winona Community Committee to order on this spot, well, rainy May 8th, 2023. My name is Ross Edie. I'll be the chairperson today. And with us, we have Counselor Sharma from the Old Kildonan Ward. And we also have from our administration, we have Mr. Rockwinder Hare, and we have Mr. Peter Prinsloo. I'll begin with we are meeting here in the home traditional lands of the Anishinaabe, Innu, and Dakota people, as well as the national home of the Red River Métis. And in Winnipeg, we receive our water from Shoal Lake 40 in on the eastern borders of Manitoba, and we get a lot of our electricity from other treaty areas. And so now we're going to move to, we have a special meeting in order to deal with a plan approval at 3640 Ferrier in the new area called
Highland Point.
Highland Point. And I believe we have a delegation, Mr. Clerk, in regards to this plan approval.
Yes, we do. We have Rachel Richard here.
Mr. Clerk, do we need a leave of absence motion for Council?
You're moving, so okay. All those in favor of a leave of absence for Councilor Santos?
For a personal family matter.
Yeah, personal family matter, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So moved.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, yep. That's passed. Now I guess we can move on to delegations.
That's right. So we have Rachel Richard here on behalf of the planning team to give us an overview on the matter.
Excellent.
Good morning, Rachel. If you can hear us, if you want to go ahead and give us your presentation. Thank you.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you perfectly.
Excellent. Well, just want to say thank you for making time for this special meeting. Appreciate it. We're anxious to get started on this project. So, just really appreciate you guys making the time for this. So after, let me share my screen here just to give you an idea. So after receiving the feedback from the meeting on April 25th, looked again at our central amenity space and just did a little bit of tweaking and were able to fit in a playground. So I'll show you here. Where we are proposing to place the playground. So this is our central amenity space here on the site. As I had mentioned in our other meeting, Broad Street has a sort of a standard playground that they put on all of the projects, and it does fit quite nicely in this central space here. We're going to have a lot of passive surveillance from residents in the building and a nice central location for any children in this project to play. And I'll just give you an idea of the playground. If anyone's interested, this would be the standard option. We got a slide, some little imaginative play area here, different climbing features and such. So I'm here this morning to request that, I'm here this morning to request that the playground be added as a condition of approval for plan approval for this project.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Rachel, for coming back and giving the opportunity to have a second look at this. Could you go back to that, zoom into the playground area, just remind you?
Absolutely.
They're keeping all the existing features that were there before, the dog run, the community garden area, the seating area, and you've just added the playground now, correct?
Correct. I'll just share my screen here again, and I'll go back to this plan. Yeah, so in the previous plan, these are two covered seating areas. We just had this one on the other side of the sidewalk, and this maintenance shed was kind of sitting over here. So it wasn't a lot of changes we needed to make to fit the playground.
What is the uptake of your community gardens at your other locations in Winnipeg? Do you find people are using those?
So across, not just in Winnipeg, but across our portfolio, we actually have wait lists for the community gardens.
Excellent.
Very popular.
And I do intend on moving this as a condition, as you've requested today. So that's what we'll be doing a little bit later in the agenda. I'll be moving that anyways.
Thank you.
My colleague will be in agreement. In terms of the actual play structure area, later on, maybe you can give it some thought and talk with our planner. Would you want to put a floating bench, like a bench just outside in that area as well?
Yes, absolutely. Actually, we quite often put benches around the playground for parents to sit.
Right. So maybe that's something, you know, we can talk offline later before you submit the formal plans at permitting stage.
Yeah, that's not an issue at all.
What age group is the play structure for?
The play structure, I believe it's for 6 to 12.
Or maybe the younger age, perhaps. One or the other, right?
No, 6 to 12 years old.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't stop the three-year-olds from going on there either, though.
No.
As long as the parents allow.
Yeah, good. All right. And the shed that you have, the maintenance shed, that's just off to the side there?
Yep.
Good. Do you have another picture of this seating area, the covered seating area, what it looks like in real life, sort of?
You know what? Let me take a look here.
Maybe at another property, or do you have another property you can bring up quickly? Sorry, I didn't give you the heads up on that.
That's okay. This would be, this is what it looks like here. It has a shed roof, it has benches, and then it's next to the sidewalk, and it will have a level lip. Here it looks like it's, you know, raised above the ground, but it's not. It's accessible as well.
That was my question. Yeah, because it looks like it's not accessible, but it is, in fact.
Yes.
In the front. And also on the playground, usually there's a bit of a lip all around, but we need to make sure that strollers and wheelchairs can get into that area as well.
Yes.
So take a close look at that before you build.
Yes, it'll be against the sidewalk here, so we can have a spot where there is a letdown for strollers and
then the trash receptacle. We'll just be mindful of where that goes. I was just at a community cleanup on Friday in another development in the area, and we thought the trash can was in a good spot, but now they're saying because of the doggy poop bags, it's too close to the seating area and it's creating a real smell in the summer. So where do you envision those trash receptacles going? Or we can figure that out later, but not close to seating, I guess, would be a good idea.
Yes, of course. And we do have, in our dog runs, we'll have a doggy bag, I don't know what you call them, mounted to the fence so that residents, if they forget their bags, can clean up. And then, of course, we have our on-site maintenance and our on-site staff that are doing site checks pretty much daily to keep the sites clean.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. I think that's good. No further questions. Thanks again for revising the plan. I think this is something that families will really enjoy. That's what we've been hearing for the last several years, is just more opportunities for play.
Thank you.
Spaces. So thank you, Rachel. You must be excited to be in this development. Highland Point, I did drive through it not too long ago, and it's really taking shape nicely.
So, yes. Yeah. Our teams in Winnipeg are excited. Absolutely. I haven't personally been to the site. I haven't been out to Manitoba yet. Just waiting for your winter to maybe end a little bit.
It's done. Well, this week it's done. We're in the mid-20s starting tomorrow, I think.
Yeah. Oh, excellent.
Well, feel free to reach out to me when you do come. Love to meet you.
Excellent.
I'm sure we'll be seeing you again for future projects.
Hope so.
Okay. Thank you, Rachel.
Right. She can listen in while we deliberate. Mm-hmm. All right. So there's no other delegations, Mr.
No further delegations.
All right. Okay. Councillor Sharma, did you have any questions for our planner?
I don't think so. We do have a condition of approval that we've discussed. Okay. If you wanted to read that out into the record.
I would be happy to, yes.
Okay. Is there anything else you wanted to add? I mean, the trash can, you've noted that. And extra benches around the play structure.
Yes, I have noted that. So just to give a refresh of the development, two multifamily buildings, 169 units, 254 parking spaces, amenity area, including a dog run, gardens, seating, and a playground. The condition of approval is as follows. The development shall include a play structure in accordance with the location, design, and specifications presented in the plans attached as Appendix A to the satisfaction of the Director of Planning, Property, and Development.
And those opportunities to add the benches is not an issue. We can do that later.
That's correct, yes. The condition would require the amenity space to be to the satisfaction of the director, and we can certainly take a look at that. And
you're going to converse with me.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yes.
Okay, excellent. Mr. Chair, I'd like to move plan approval.
With the additional condition. All right. Excellent. Did you want to say a couple words before I call the vote? Nope.
I'm really excited about this development, and I'll take you there for a tour sometime and describe to you what's happening and many families moving in currently. And so it's very exciting for Seymour Pacific to be in that neighborhood. And we need affordable housing in terms of rental. And this will be the first multifamily in that community. So very, very exciting.
Right on.
Okay, question.
Then I'll call the question. All those in favor?
Aye.
Nobody's opposed. That is carried. Councillor Sharma, are you moving adjournment?
Move adjournment. Thank you.
All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Nobody's opposed. That is carried. We are adjourned.